Let's talk about Dcis of the breast. Patients see me all the time with the impression that they have breast cancer. Dcis is not true breast cancer. I like to explain it to women as precancerous. To understand how we approach Dcis as surgeons, let's talk about the basics. Dcis stands for ductal carcinoma in situ. The breast is designed to deliver milk to the nipple during pregnancy. The milk is produced in a part of the breast called the lobule and travels to the nipple through tubes called ducts. There are thousands of these duct units throughout the breast. About 80% of breast cancers come from the duct cell, whereas only 20% come from the lobule cell. Let's magnify one of these ducts. As the duct cells become cancerous, they are stuck inside of the duct tube, and when they have not invaded through the wall of the duct, they are called in situ. Only after the cancerous cells have invaded through the wall of the duct and into the surrounding breast tissue are they considered invasive breast cancer. Because there are no lymphatic channels or blood vessels inside of the ducts, Dcis cells cannot travel from the breast to lymph nodes and cannot spread. They are stuck in the duct, which is why I tell women these are precancerous because, by definition, the bad cells cannot get out of the breast to cause harm. How do we find Dcis? Well, almost always it is found incidentally on mammograms. As the Dcis cells form in the ducts, they grow abnormally and many cells die. As the abnormal cells die, they leave calcium deposits in the ducts, which show up on the mammograms as spots of calcium. Radiology doctors are especially concerned if the calcium deposits on the mammogram are new, changing, or in the shape of branching ducts. Very occasionally, a woman may have a lump that they feel or bloody fluid coming out of their nipple. That can be a sign of Dcis cells in the breast, but vast majority are found on screening mammograms. Ultrasounds don't help a whole lot, MRI may help. Once a mammogram shows a suspicious area, we always recommend starting with a needle biopsy. The abnormal area is biopsied using a mammogram machine to guide the needle in, since the calcium is easiest to see on the mammogram. Once the area is biopsied, we leave a small titanium marker in the exact area that was biopsied. This is so we can find the same area again in the future if the biopsy turns out to be cancerous. Once a biopsy shows Dcis, the first treatment is surgery. There are two types of surgery for Dcis in the breast, either a lumpectomy, which is removing a portion of the breast, or a mastectomy, which is removing the entire breast. For a lumpectomy, we usually need something as surgeons to help us know we are removing the correct piece of tissue. Dcis is usually not something you can feel, and you can't see it with your naked eye. The most common way of finding the area is for a radiologist to place a wire through the skin with a J-shaped hook at the end that prevents it from pulling out. The tip of the wire at the J-hook will be placed as close as possible to the clip that was left from the needle biopsy that originally found the Dcis. When the surgery is performed, the surgeon finds the wire just below the skin, follows it to where the area of the breast should be removed. Once we remove the portion of the breast that we think contains the end of the wire, this should contain the biopsy clip and the bad area of Dcis and calcium. We actually x-ray the piece of the breast tissue outside the body to be sure the biopsy clip and calcium deposits are actually in it. This is called a wire-localized lumpectomy. Unfortunately, the pathology doctors cannot tell us right away if there are bad cells at the edge of the removed portion of the breast. We usually do not know if the edges of the tissue are clear of all Dcis for several days, because the pathology doctors need time to process the specimen. We would ideally like to have at least 2 millimeters of normal breast tissue surrounding the area of bad Dcis cells. Dcis tends to crawl through the duct they are growing in and do not grow in a perfect sphere. So unfortunately, even in the best of hands, a lumpectomy for Dcis may have bad cells extending to the edge of the removed tissue in about 20% of cases. If the bad Dcis cells are up to the edge of the removed tissue, we call this a positive margin, and we usually recommend that we return to surgery to remove more tissue in that area, called a repeat lumpectomy. Now, the one thing that is important to know when we offer a lumpectomy for Dcis is that radiation to the remaining breast tissue is usually recommended. If we don't give radiation after removing a piece of Dcis, we usually say the risk of future Dcis or even invasive breast cancer is nearly 50%. However, if you do give radiation, the chance of having Dcis or cancer regrow is more around 10%. so you need routine mammograms for follow-up, usually once a year is plenty. And since the Dcis is stuck in the duct and cannot get out, we do not need to check armpit lymph nodes here. The other option for surgery is a mastectomy. If a woman has a large area of Dcis based on mammograms or MRI, or they have multiple areas throughout the breast, or the person cannot have radiation or does not want radiation, then a mastectomy may be a good idea. The nipple can be left in place doing what we call a nipple-sparing mastectomy, although I would say most of the time the nipple is removed. This is because the blood flow to the nipple may not be enough to allow the skin to stay alive after a mastectomy, or because we are worried the Dcis cells have crawled up the duct and into the nipple itself. Although, even though I said Dcis cannot get into the lymph nodes, sometimes when we remove the entire Dcis area, we find that a part has invasive breast cancer that the needle biopsy missed. So if we are doing a mastectomy, that is our one chance to check the lymph nodes for cancer via the sentinel lymph node biopsy technique, explained in a different video. It is probably a good idea to do the lymph node check during the mastectomy for Dcis on the small chance you find invasive cancer in the breast after you take it out. Now, because there is no breast tissue left after a mastectomy, there is no reason to give radiation. So a mastectomy does prevent the need for radiation with Dcis of the breast. And as far as breast reconstruction, that is a topic for a different talk, but suffice it to say that reconstruction should definitely be an option after a mastectomy for Dcis. So after a lumpectomy for Dcis is done, we let the patient heal for about 1 month, and then radiation is given to the remaining breast. After surgery and radiation, you should see medical oncology to discuss medicine that blocks the effects of estrogen on the breast tissue. This can help decrease the chance of Dcis regrowing or new areas of breast cancer forming. I hope this helps. Don't forget to subscribe below and check out other videos I've made explaining mastectomy surgery, breast biopsies, and sentinel lymph node surgery more. Take care.